Steven Cudeno, KOR Sports, here with the great Abel Sanchez. Man, it's been a while, bro. It's been a long time since I've talked to you. Yeah, well, so obviously here at 360, Callum Walsh looked incredible, man.
You know, unfortunately, I was in the back. Oh. I didn't see it, but I heard he looked very good. Mm-hmm. Let's see what he does in the next one, and let's see how he progresses.
Who are you working with?
Actually, nobody right now.
Oh, okay.
I'm trying to lay low, and I just help Ben tonight in the corner, and I come to top shows just to mingle, but
yeah,
I'm taking easy playing golf.
Man, you can't be mad at that. What's your handicap?
I'm about a 14.
Oh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Yeah. I wanted Canelo's like a 9-10, he said, so.
Canelo's a hell of an athlete. Yeah,
right.
So it's the shit out of the ball, so.
Right.
It's easier when you do it that way. When you're young, it's a lot easier to.
Right, exactly. Yeah, with those fast twitch muscles out. Yeah. Yeah.
Just muscles.
Right.
Fast or slow, it doesn't matter.
Right. Just speaking of Canelo, man, fighting Bivol. Bivol's a big guy, 175.
I thought that got called off.
No, I know that. Right. Did this just happen?
Yesterday, I think.
Because as far as I know, they're still releasing tickets.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I think it's. There's a lot of kind of motion. Go ahead. I feel like there is a contingent kind of trying to push for Bivol not being able to fight. I know Vladimir's spoken up about it, but as far as I know, it's still on.
Bivol's a very good technical fighter.
Mm-hmm.
Great amateur background. But I think Canelo right now he's in his time. Right? Bivol doesn't have anything to threaten him other than technique.
Mm-hmm.
To beat Canelo, you're going to have to back him up. You're gonna have to be strong. You're gonna have to be able to take a shot. But most important, you're gonna have to try to be the one in charge. And if you don't do that against Canelo, you saw in the BJ Saunders, is that BJ?
Saunders? Yeah, yeah.
Saunders, and you saw in the plant fight, by the fifth or sixth round, Canelo was doing things like he does on the bag. He just let him shit go that just he had no threat in front of him. So. Can't back him up, it's going to be difficult for him.
Mm-hmm.
It's only three guys, in my opinion, that can give Canelo a hard time. Whether they can beat him or not, who knows? But it's three guys. Beterbiev is one of them. David Beterbiev is another one. And I think if Golovkin gets in the kind of shape he used to be before, he goes back to being the stalker instead of allowing people to, like he thinks he can box. I'm not saying he's not a good boxer, he is, but his forte is his strength. You know, he goes down, hunts you down and stalks you and hits you everywhere, and he succumbed to things like that. So if he can get in that kind of shape and take that kind of style in the fight, I think he gives Canelo a hell of a fight. But those are the only three guys that can give him a fight. I think the goal is about a 70-35 for me.
70-35? With the options that Canelo had, right, it was Charlo and Benavidez.
Look, all these guys, if he fights Charlo, they're going to say he's avoiding Bivol. If he fights Bivol, he's avoiding Charlo. If he fights Benavidez, he's avoiding Charlo. So you know what? He's in a no-win situation just like we were when we were with an addict. He has to fight who he feels and his team feels is the right opponent for him next. Forget about what everybody's saying. I think his resume speaks for itself. He probably has the best resume in boxing right now. So what anybody says doesn't matter. It's what's best for the sport and best for Canelo.
With Triple G, obviously that's the second fight of the deal if they both get past their fights, which is a big if.
Yeah. Well, they should.
Right.
They should.
Triple G is almost 40 years old, maybe will be 40 by then, I'm not sure.
His birthday's April the 8th, so I think he just turned 39.
Okay. So.
Oh no, maybe he's going on to 40. Wow. We're in March.
So
he'll
be almost.
I don't know.
But, I mean, I don't know, we haven't seen a whole lot of Triple G more recently. I guess, will the Murata fight maybe tell you what you need to know as far as what he'll look like against Canelo the third time?
Murata's going to pose a little bit of a problem. You have to remember, Gennady's Gennady. If Gennady's in any kind of shape, it should be I shouldn't say an easy fight, but it should be a fight that he wins.
Tacos 1986 is the best tacos in America. The Abel of Sanchez, right here.
Anyway, I think that Gennady has to be in shape. If he's in shape, he beats Murata. Murata doesn't pose that big a threat for him. But it's still a tough fight. It's not an easy fight.
Mm. With like you said, you have the backup Canelo. Do you think, you know, Triple G had a lot of success in those first two fights with backing up Canelo, but I feel like there wasn't a whole lot of body work on the part of Triple G.
One of the guys went to the body. Canelo's a hell of a body puncher too, and he never did. You know, sometimes we have a guy in front of you as those two stars like they are in their strengths. Sometimes it's difficult to do what you do best because they're trying to take that away from you. Canelo could have gone to the body too. Golovkin didn't allow him. Golovkin wanted to go to the body, but Canelo didn't allow him. So it just because that's what you've done in the past with other opponents doesn't mean you can do with the particular guy that's in front of you right now.
Right.
They fought 24 great rounds. Unfortunately, in the second fight, he boxed a little more than I wanted him to, but listen, they're both great fighters.
You got great fights, man, and I really feel it's kind of one of those like Pacquiao Marquez situations where, you know, maybe Triple G hasn't, you know, been out there too much, maybe hasn't looked spectacular, but when they get in with each other, it's always going to be one of those classic, like, grudge match, like, we don't like each other, so we're going to go at it.
Yeah, the only difference in that would be that Gennady is getting a little older, so that could make a difference. Who knows? We'll have to find, like you said, it could be a barometer on really where he's at, but he's got a good coach, man. He's got a good coach, and hopefully JB can engineer a Canelo win finally.
Another big one I wanted to take on, man, Spence Ugas. Big welterweights. Ugas coming off the Pacquiao win. Spence, you know, just coming off the Garcia win. Always just looks like Spence, you know, one of the best in the world.
When Spence and when that class of Olympics came out, I predicted or I thought that Spence and Marcus Brown would be the cream of the crop, would be the champions. And fortunately, I was right. And the only problem, Marcus Brown has had some issues, private issues. But Spence, I think, I don't think he's even reached.
Light?
I don't think he's even reached his potential yet. I think that car accident kind of derailed him a little bit, but I think he still has a long way to go. I think he's a very good fighter. I think he beats Ugas. Not easy, but he beats Ugas.
If that were to happen and we actually see Ugas, I'm sorry, Crawford and Spence. Do you think we will see Crawford and Spence?
I sure hope so. Mm-hmm. I sure hope so because that's the kind of fight, a throwback to the Leonard, Hagler, Hearns, Benitez and Duran era. I hope so because that's the fight that I think a lot of people are clamoring for. I still think that Spence beats Crawford. I think the bigger man beats the smaller man. But it's a heck of a fight. I would love to see that.
Abel, man, I love picking your brain on boxing, bro. It's the best. You're very knowledgeable. Thank you so much for your time always, bro. I'm very grateful for it. Thank you very much.